I don't know if I can do this or not.
It's not good.
All right. Okay. It's all yours.
Hello, everybody. How great is this? Riley, Raquel, it's their wedding day. We've been all sitting here for months about this. How great is this? Number one is I want to thank Nick, Terry, Donna, and Brian for putting this beautiful venue together. How great is this? A spectacular backyard for your wedding. When you guys grew up together, how great is this? And you're doing it in your own house. This is so awesome. Thank you, Nick. Thank you, Donna, Brian, Nick.
Your sister,
Terry. So if anybody doesn't know me out there, I'm known as Uncle Kev. I'm Terry's brother. And from day one, I've seen these two kids and from the get-go. And it's so nice. It's actually spectacular that they're getting married. They high school sweethearts, if anybody didn't know that, they are. And went off to college and had some fun and come back and reunited. And they just love each other. This is awesome. This is very cool for me. And when they got engaged, they came to the house. He texted me and they came in the house and they go, Kevin, would you do the ceremony for us? And I was like, that is like the nicest thing I've ever heard in my life. We're very family oriented here, as we'll get into. And it's such a pleasure and an honor to be here to do this for you guys, watching you grow up together. And it's actually overwhelming. I do a lot of this stuff and I'm overwhelmed with this beautiful day today. And we're gonna get this stuff. So. But in the first, I'd like to also take a minute to give some respect for the people that could not be here because of death, whatever. We have the Rileys, the Gilmans, the Hendersons, and the Riley boys, which is Jim, Jackie, Bob Riley, and of course, the old man, Big Daddy, Frank Riley. They would love to be here, and they were wedding guys, and we miss them. And Uncle Raj Gilman, we miss him, and they couldn't be here. And for some of the other people that couldn't be here, which is Nick Andrews Sr., Bucky, he couldn't be here for health reasons, and we want to give him a little shout out. Hey, Bucks. I know you're watching. We're here. We're doing it for you. So in the big picture, I've known these guys for a long time. These kids are great. Raquel, look at these beautiful girlfriends. Your friendship is huge. And Riley, you have all these shitbag friends. And I call them shitbags, and that's a good thing up here in Chico. That means you do dumb things, but you have a heart as big as the moon. And we love it. And I call them all shitbags, and they'll tell you that. And that's a good thing. Obviously, we're doing things a little outside and a little different outside of the world of the church stuff. So we have a little bit of freedom. Friendship. These guys, I've known each other for a long time. I've been around the block a few times. And whenever these guys have a function, their friends show up. You have the best friend base ever. These guys have known each other forever, and they love each other, and they respect each other. Raquel and your girlfriends, Mackenzie and all the girls, you have such a friendship that is a big part of life. And whenever in the future you guys have support system, it's unbelievable the support system you guys have, and it's really awesome. And in the big picture of the family, all our kids, nephews, nieces, on the Kilman side, the Riley side, the Henderson side, they've all turned out great. And they're successful and they're happy, and it's really, really awesome to be up here and to look at the first one going down. And there's going to be many more, and it's awesome. And they're so happy and successful, and you couldn't ask as an uncle, you couldn't ask for anything better to see how that happens in the family-oriented in this world that we have. And the Raleigh Gilman Henderson family is just insane, and we welcome the Hendersons into our world. And you guys are going to be so happy, and we are so happy to have you. It's really, really, really awesome. And Raleigh is so overachieving. And that's kind of what happens in our world over here. So in respect to everybody, we're supposed to keep this short and sweet. So they didn't want to go too far, they want to go too big. So with that in mind, we are going to start the ceremony. You ready?
Yes.
You ready to do this?
Yes.
All right, I'm ready.
Are you?
Do we have the rings?
Vows.
Oh, we have their vows. Oh, can I stop this for 1 second? I forgot something. I know, I'm nervous. I never get nervous at this stuff. We are going to do an Irish blessing. I was told to say this. And so, here we go. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. And the rains fall softly upon your fields. We dodge that bullet. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hands. God bless you. So Riley's got some vows.
Should have listened to you. Raquel, when I think about you and I think about a different kind of love story. When I first met you, I was a kid that loved hanging out with my friends, playing sports, didn't have any time for girls. When you walked into my life, everything froze.
Oh, Robert, guys.
Oh, this is great. This is fucking great. Go for it. Yeah. Pause. You're in, dude. You're in.
Pause for dramatic effect. Okay. When you walked into my life, everything froze. It was like a moment from Romeo and Juliet, or maybe the movie Superbad. When Jules walked into Seth's life in his cooking class. For me, I was in Spanish class. Young, definitely dumb, and unaware that my life was going to change. I remember that moment so vividly. That is when it all changed. Shake out again. Those feelings have been something that I've never been able to explain until now. My endearment and appreciation for you, shake out, has stemmed over the years through our travels, the experiences and courage to tackle life's challenges head first. Promise to continue to be strong for us in our everyday lives. Just not today. I vow to be the man that you fell in love with and continue to fall in love with every day. During my struggles, I look to you for knowledge and support to do what's right for not only me, but us. I vowed to continue to be the funniest person you have ever met and keep the jokes fresh. I just need you to promise to not tell anyone that my jokes are all from movies. Thank you for letting me bang my drums and vent to you at all hours of the day. I'm caught in your sunbeam and I only spin for you. My point is, I'm so madly in love with you. I vow to be everything you need and everything you want in this life.
Thank you.
way no longer. Oh, God.
How you gonna top that?
Yeah. I'm not gonna be able to top that. And my biggest fear is speaking in front of people, so.
Doing better than me.
Okay. My sweet Neen Bear, your love and trust makes me a better person. You've been there for my greatest challenges. You've encouraged me to grow and helped me believe in myself and become the person I am today. When I'm with you, I know I can do anything. I'm so proud to finally get to call you my husband. You're my second half, my best friend, and my one true love. There's still a part of me that can't believe that today is the day I actually get to marry you. I promise to love you, to be your best friend, to respect and support you, to be patient with you, to work together to achieve our goals, and to love you unconditionally forever and always. That's it.
Got it.
You're so in trouble.
That was amazing.
Very nice. It's pretty awesome stuff. I love that stuff. The rings. Riley, do you take Raquel to be your wife, to have and to hold this day forward for better and worse? In sickness and health, and if we're richer or upper middle class, do you love and cherish till death you part?
You bet your ass I do.
Good answer. Ring, Raquel. Raquel. Do you take Riley to be your wife, no, I'm just kidding, to be your husband, to have and to hold, forward for better or worse, in sickness and health, and for richer and upper middle class, to love and cherish till the day you part?
I do.
Through the internet and the universal life, I pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, the Andrews.
please join me in welcoming the newest newlyweds of 2022, straight into their first dance as man and wife.
Christmas lights up till January. This is our place, we made the rules. And there's a dazzling haze, a mysterious way about you, dear. Have I known you 20 seconds or 20 years? Can I go? Crash in the living room. This is our place, we make the call. And I'm highly suspicious that everyone who sees you wants you. I've loved you 3 summers now, honey, but I want them all. Can I go?
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mackenzie, the maid of honor and the bride's best friend of almost 10 years now. First off, I just wanted to say how beautiful this wedding is and how amazing you look tonight, Raquel. And Riley, of course. I've never seen you guys happier. When I first met Raquel on the PV cheer team my freshman year, you could definitely say I was a little intimidated by her. especially with her being the cheer coach's daughter and all. But as soon as I got to spend some time with her, I was immediately drawn to her and her firecracker personality. And we've been connected at the hip ever since. Raquel is probably one of the nicest, funniest people I have ever met, and definitely the most protective over me. The only person that might be funnier and more protective over me is probably Riley. Raquel and I have shared so many fun memories over the past years, especially since we were roommates for like 5 of them. From our parties at the 6th Ave house, working together at the cottage, trips to Hollywood stalking people from our favorite TV shows, to her moving to Reno with Riley and me visiting her every other week because I didn't know how to live on my own without her. Thankfully, Riley was a good sport about that. Raquel is and has always been the life of the party, and she knows how to make anyone who walks into a room feel special. She's honest, sometimes a little too honest. She loves deeply, and she's one of the strongest people I know. Riley is a very lucky man to be marrying such a genuine and beautiful person. Not For those of you who don't know, Raquel and Riley actually dated in high school. Riley ended up going off to college and they went their separate ways, but I think we all knew, including Riley and Raquel, that they were always meant to find their way back to one another. And trust me, when Riley moved back to Chico, it didn't take them long. Riley is also one of my best friends. I've known him since junior high. Shout out to Marsh. Him and I have always been good friends, but since he's been with Raquel, we've gotten a lot closer. Riley's one of the sweetest, most caring guys I know. I've always been able to tell him anything, and he's always listened to me and given me the best advice, even when it's petty girl drama. I've always known Riley was the one for Raquel. No one has treated her better and loved her more selflessly and unconditionally than Riley has. Riley brings out the absolute best version of her, and I know I'm leaving my best friend in good hands. She's marrying into such a loving and amazing family. I only hope I can be lucky enough to find the love you two share for one another someday. And to that, please raise a glass with me to Raquel and Riley. Cheers to love and to laughter and to happily ever after. Love you guys.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, cheers, cheers.
We're literally shaking the entire day.
I'm not done yet.
I'm making eye contact, dude.
I just said that.
Oh, all right, all right, all right.
All right, guys.
So I thought now was a good time to practice my stand-up routine. I appreciate everybody being out here tonight, especially for my little brother. He is my little brother. So I would like to clear that up for anybody who doesn't know. I am the oldest brother. It may not always look like it, may not act like it. But he is my little brother. The thing about Riley is he doesn't always act like my little brother. And I want to go back, all the way back, to the old days. And I'm going to tell you guys a story about probably the first time, I think I was about six years old. So that would have made Riley about 3. Might have been a little bit older, but what it was is Riley taught me that there are consequences to my actions. So I'm in my bedroom, and being the oldest, you know, you like your alone time. So I'm in my room. And I am playing with some toys. For those of you that are familiar with them, they are called Digimon. And yeah, that's a good telltale sign of like, what a weirdo. Why don't you just play with Pokemon? Like, you're already a hipster and you're 6 years old. Okay, so I'm playing with my Digimon toys. Well, Riley comes in and he just wants to hang out with his older brother. So he comes in, and I've got all my toys set up on my bed. He gets up on my bed because I am not giving him the attention that a friend would give one, and starts jumping on my bed. And I'm going, please stop, please stop, because you're jumping on my goddamn Digimon. He keeps jumping, and I go, fine. And I swipe. Well, Riley goes flying across the room and hits his arm on a toy box. And he breaks his arm. So he's crying. I'm realizing I don't have all those Digimon that I once had. And my mom comes in. She takes Riley to the hospital. And my dad comes in and he sits me down and he goes, I think it's important you understand that you really hurt your brother. I had never had a feeling like that before. And I realized that there are consequences to your actions. And I learned that if you jump on my fucking Digimon, I'm gonna break your arm. I still have them. Try me. So fast forward a few years. Me and Riley, you know, still going at it like brothers do. You know, you're just going at it, but we get along too. And I remember we got into a fight one time. I don't exactly remember how it started, but I start wailing on Riley. He grabs some pillows from the couch to try to shield himself. And my mom comes over and she's probably pulling her hair out because she has two kids and just going nuts. And she goes, come on, you can't do that. So at the end of it, I think she fills in my dad. And my dad goes, hey, you know you're my favorite, right? No, so what actually happened, so he goes, you know, I feel bad for you, right? No, so what he actually says is he goes, hey, I don't know if you've noticed, but your brother's getting pretty big. If you might want to start being his friend right around now, because in a couple years, I think he's going to kick your ass. So, believe it or not, I actually took that to heart. And I, you know, for me and Riley, it was always easy. I didn't understand. I know a lot of siblings, they go through a lot of shit. And Riley has just always been my best friend. And fast forward to high school. We're seniors. Riley's a freshman. And everywhere I go, some of them are here tonight. Some of my friends are here tonight. Everywhere we go, they go, so where's Riley? And I'm going, ah, maybe it's the same. I go hang out with his friends. Maybe they go, where's Ryan? Not the same. Yeah, it's not. So I just looked at that, and that, you know, it's funny to joke about, but man, is that the ultimate compliment as a person when your little brother, people just want to be around you, Riley. People love you. So, kind of to wrap this whole thing up, I did look up some things about speeches, and it said a couple things not to do. One, don't talk about yourself, shit. 2, don't tell inside jokes
in a books.
But I could not be happier. That I'm your older brother. And there are a lot of times that I think you've been the older brother.
The good brother.
And I love you for that. I thank you for that. And Raquel coming into this family, I can't wait to be the one on the outside when you guys are telling inside jokes and I'm going, I don't fucking get it. Because you guys do that. I see it in you. And I love it. And I thank you for everything that you guys have done for each other. And thank you for everything you have done for me, my family. I love you guys. Nice. Oh, fuck yeah. Who's up? Who's up?
Okay, I'm gonna try to top that one. Wish me luck. Mine's very short and sweet. So I'm Raquel's sister, for those of you that don't know me. I'm her older sister.
Everybody knows you're the old one.
Oh, thanks. I'm the old one. Everybody knows it, apparently.
Everybody knows she's old. For the record.
I want you both to know how happy it makes me that I get to share your wedding day with both of you. Raquel, I will never forget our childhood memories of playing in the mud when Dad was irrigating and literally riding the go-kart all around Richfield like it was our town. I don't know how we got away with that. I'm so glad we've grown closer over time. Riley, I know you are the perfect man for my sister, and I'm so glad to see her so happy. And I know that you'll treat her right forever. So I'm just glad to see you both so happy. I love you both so much. Congratulations. Yeah, thank you.
So we're passing it.
Nope.
No. Sit down.
Now you have to say thank you to everybody for coming in. So.
Oh. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. From Raquel and I, we just want to say thank you guys so much for making it out here. Those East Coast rallies. My new family. Thank you guys. I don't know how they got up here and didn't cry and blubber like a little girl, but I'm better now, so it's all shaken out. Thank you guys so much for being here and celebrating with us, and we really do love you all. It means the world to us. This is the best party of all time, so in our book, so we're happy to share this chapter with you guys. Thank you.
I just want to add thank you as well. It's off. Oh. I just wanted to add thank you as well.
Yeah.
That's all I got.
Look at the two of you dancing that way. Lost in the moment. In each other's face. So much love going on in this place. Like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one. She told me so. And she still means the world to me. Just so you know. So be careful when you hurt my girl. Changes.
All right, give it up for the father of the bride and the bride, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, we'd like to call the groom and his mother out to the dance floor. We need the mother of the groom. There she is.
Got a call from a friend about a friend. It's the news no one ever wants to hear. It hit me like a punch and took my breath. He was just getting into his best friend. Yes, something like that'll shake you up, wake you up. So I stopped off at a Texaco, bought a Slim Jim and a Coke, parked out by the water just to watch that river flow. Grabbed my guitar from the backseat, wrote a song just for me. And I sung it for the blue sky and the couple live oak trees. I thought of home, grabbed my phone from my pocket, and I called mama.
We're not done yet. The bridal party's got a bit of a surprise for their mothers.
Let's make it back to the table.